Oh my gosh. So I got a new cassette player, got a new cassette deck, dual cassette deck even. It's replacing my old one, which I didn't really like. It was honestly really cheap. It was from eBay. Modern, which I learned for cassette tapes and cassette decks and cassette players, is kind of not the way to go. So I'm learning, and you're going to be hopefully learning with me, but welcome to the video. Let's go ahead and jump right into my new thing and what I've done with it all and all of the fun knickknacks, do's and dibbles and whatnots. Yeah, I don't know. Let's just...
Here is the machine itself. You'll have to pardon some of the dust. You can only get these things so clean. They are quite old. It's the Onkyo TA-RW244. Stereo cassette tape can play on one of the two cassette players featured. There is some chips in the paint, but it's purely cosmetic on playback deck A. This one can only do playback, unlike playback deck B, which can do playback and recording. Recording can be done through the two RCA input in the back. They also have an output of the same demeanor, which is to be expected. This is super standard, as well as the power cable, which is also super standard. It's not super interesting in the back. It's not like super schmancy fancy, but I mean, hey, gets the job done there.
Now, you could hook that up to a radio, a CD player, your Xbox, it doesn't really matter, but mine is hooked up to an adapter to a 3.5mm and then straight to lightning cable. And yes, I record cassettes straight from my output on the device is hooked up straight to my receiver, which is a TSR-700 from Yamaha. This is a Dolby Atmos compatible 8K pass-through receiver, so it is quite pricey and definitely overkill for something like this, but I do oftentimes watch movies and stuff that would allow me to actually watch and use something like this. But it is hooked up to my cassette deck. I'm happy it's hooked up to my cassette deck, but yeah, let's play a cassette or two so you can just kind of hear what it sounds like. I have some copyright free sounds of nature, peaceful ocean surf. I'm like 90% sure you can't copyright the ocean, so it should be good. Let's go ahead and play it, put it in. We can go ahead and open that up and just go ahead and slide that in there carefully. Like to be careful, although I know these things are pretty robust. And I'm really excited to show you this because this right here, guys, this is actually a VU meter. So if we can go ahead and play some ocean sounds here. And as you can see, there is an electric tape counter right there, which is super, super cool. Or digital tape counter, if you want to call it that, which is probably a more accurate sound or a more accurate way to say that. But look at that VU meter. This is the main thing that drew me to it. That's wonderful. Now I'm sure you can hear that quite well, but this is playing on speakers that are set up across the room. So you won't really get a good crisp feel for how it sounds here, but later in the video I will get a better sound report. This is more just to show the features of the actual deck itself, so I'm going to go back to doing that. I'm going to turn off the actual sounds itself, like the ocean sounds. I'm going to mute it on this
side. Now, this does feature a reverse mode because it does actually feature, as you can see, computer control auto reverse mode. Now, I'm going to go ahead and try to demonstrate this. I haven't actually gotten it to work because I haven't experimented with it all that much, but this is not the cassette tape to use. Let's use a clearer one. Let's go ahead and swap that out for one like this and see if we can't get that computer control auto reverse to go through. So essentially what that means is that once the tape is actually done going all the way through its tape reel, theoretically, if I put it in reverse mode, which should signal that little thing right there, as you guys can see, it's not in reverse mode. Now it is, not is, not is. So now that it is, theoretically, if I go ahead and play this tape all the way through, then by the time it ends, it should go ahead, understand that it ended, and the computer should control it and make it reverse back by itself. So I'm going to go ahead and fast forward and see if we can't get it to do that. So the fast forwarding section right here also goes quite fast. This is a good demonstration of that. This is the regular fast forward speed. There is the tape deck counter if you want to see it, as that is going quite quickly. Now, the actual tape itself is about 45 minutes on each end. It's exactly 45 minutes on each end. And just if you're curious, here is an exact replica while that tape is going. This is from the exact same pack. It's a Maxwell, I don't even know, Maxwell UR position normal. I like them. They're clear. I like the clear ones so that way I can kind of see
where the tape is a little bit better. Makes me feel a little bit more in control. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and cut back for when this tape is done going through. It does usually take about like 90 seconds to get all the way through. But there's the tape counter right as it hits 1,000. I'll cut back. All right, let's go ahead and stop that now as it's getting quite close to the end of that reel. Great. So I just went ahead and stopped it at 2281. I'm just going to go ahead and play it normally. And keep in mind that auto reverse mode should be on if all indicators are correct. So now, like I said, I haven't actually demonstrated this before. But when this reel ends right here, which should be ending quite soon, it should be able to read that little mark. And the computer will read the mark at the end of every single tape, every cassette tape. It's standard as a mark that it is done. And since the actual reverse mode is turned on, the computer inside of the actual machine is going to recognize that and kick it into overdrive to go ahead and reverse the tape super, super quick. So we're going to go ahead, see if that happens. It should happen here. There it goes. Awesome. So now that tape is literally reversing. I didn't have to do anything. You saw it all on tape, which is great. So that's one of the cool functions and features that I like about this tape is that if you have a tape that's only one-sided, you don't want to play side B and you don't want to rewind it when you go to sleep or whatever. There's numerous reasons why you'd want to use this feature, but it is super, super cool to have. But this thing's quite feature rich. It's not over yet. I'm going to keep
another
showing.
Wonderful feature of this cassette deck that I love is if you want to make copies of your personal tapes, which I like to do, just if you like giving out mixtapes to people, maybe you have some friends, maybe you just want personal mixes for yourself like I do. In this instance, I want some chill music. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up, place my cassette tape inside, and I'm going to close it up, make sure it's on my recording side, and then I'm going to grab some peaceful copyright-free ocean sounds just like the last one, and I'm going to go ahead and place that into here. Let's go ahead and open it up and place it into there. Now, one of the wonderful features that we have that I'm sure you're familiar with is called dubbing. Now, there is normal speed dubbing right here, which if I just go ahead and click that, it is now copying this tape, which is playing some copyright-free ocean noises, because you can't copyright the ocean. And what it is doing is it is transferring it over to this tape right here, which is great if you want copy of your personal tapes to do whatever you want with. I'm not really sure what I'm allowed to tell you can do, because all of the record label companies are kind of indifferent on even if you're allowed to do this or not. So, yeah, but the machine exists. So if you do want to stop this dubbing, you do have to hit this button right here. This pause button will not work. And then if you would like to do super high speed dubbing, let's say you don't want to hear the tape, you just want to copy it over. If you press this high speed dubbing option right here, it's going to turn on 4 times the speed of the dub. Now, as you can see, this will copy the entire tape in about 2.5 minutes. Now that's all we really need. Go ahead and click, make sure we click the dub stop button. And then I'll even prove it right here. We'll go ahead and reverse back for a good little bit on that tape. And then we're gonna go ahead and hit play on it. There it is. Another decidedly nifty feature that I have right here is the auto space function. Now, to be honest and admit to my weaknesses, I honestly have really no clue what this does. The only real function that I can seem to get out of it is when you are in a dubbing mode. Most of the time it works for me in high speed dubbing mode. And then you have everything paused. If you go ahead and click this auto space button, it takes your tape on deck B, 10 or 9, it is not either both, it doesn't switch between the two. Little clicks forward there. So auto space right here, we are at 68. 67, that time it was 9. 77. 86, that time it was 9 as well. Alright, so it's 9 every time it appears, but... I assure you, I have seen it be 10 many times. So
Yeah, that's a pretty interesting feature as well. I really don't know why you would need that. I can't find a lot of use for it, or a lot of documentation for it. So maybe someone can let me know down in the comments below why you would need that feature, or if I'm even employing it right. But let's move on to the next
one. I know I owe this to you now. It's time for the audio. It's time for the actual music, the sound test, because that's what matters. Now, there is two things that we need to keep in mind. There is Dolby Noise Reduction. There is Dolby Noise Reduction B and Dolby Noise Reduction C, both built into the unit itself. So I'm going to go ahead and play the same song three times, one time with no Dolby Noise Reduction, one time with Dolby Noise Reduction B, and with Dolby Noise Reduction C. Now, personally, I like B the best, but it's up to you. And if you do want the full mixes, I'm going to provide them on my second channel. When that video is up, I'll link it in the comments or in the description below. But that'll be like the full 5-6 minute audio test. It will be filmed with a better microphone if you do care. So that'll be the real true test. I mean, all in all, it's kind of a little bit tinny. It's got a wider soundstage than I was thinking it would, but it also sounds like it's on tape. That's obviously what it's going to sound like, but my receiver is great. It's not anything like that. It is definitely just the quality of the cassette that I'm recording onto. Granted, that is just regular Type 1 cassette, and I am not going to be paying money for metal cassette tape when I could just buy CDs or something like that. But I am getting more and more into cassette tapes, and so I would love to hear what you guys are doing, and anything that you think that I'm doing wrong, please let me know, so that way I can learn and get better and better at this. Thank you guys all so much for watching, and thank you for checking in on me, and I will let you know when I update more things, which, I mean, I get paid eventually, so we'll probably be pretty soon. Thanks.